Circle 2.
Before we go back to the ring, next week on Worldwide Wrestling, Two Cold Scorpio and Marcus Alexander Bagwell. The Super Brawl Control Center with updates. Also, Ricky Steamboat, the Dragon, will be here. We'll also see the World Tag Team Champions, the Nasty Boys. And our main event, Harlem Heat, Cole and Kane in tag action against Johnny Van and Michael PSAs. Check your local listings for Worldwide Wrestling next week on this station. All right, we are back with you on Worldwide. And it will be Super Brawl Sunday, February 20th, exclusively on pay-per-view. Jesse, that's only 2 weeks from this Sunday.
2 weeks from this Sunday, and here comes the tag team.
Shoot up for destruction, because McLean and Cactus Jack are coming directly after you.
I guess he's talking to the Nasty Boys, because they'll be going after the Nasty Boys in the World Tag Team title at Super Brawl, and they've had their running with the...
Look, it's Larry Bud Melvin. Did you see that guy in the green?
In the audience? Really?
Looked like him on Leprechaun Day. Anyway, we'll take our focus back to the center of the ring, Tony.
Will NBC allow you to use that name? There's the bell.
Look, there's a pretty face for you right there.
Bang, bang.
You know what's interesting about this tag match that's going to happen at Super Brawl? These two guys, you know, the Nasty Boys are the champions, and they got the name, you know, Sags and Knobs Nasty. But I think when it comes to getting nasty, Cactus and Max Payne may be able to out-nasty the Nasty Boys.
Yeah, that's true. And to be successful against the Nasty Boys. Speaking of nasty, there's Nasty Ned in there. To be successful against the Nasty Boys, you have to be nasty as well. Look at Ned firing back, and that really just kind of incites Cactus Jack.
Big arm whip. Nasty Ned across. Ooh, he caught Cactus coming in with a boot. And Nasty Ned living up to his name. He's biting him, Tony, right on the bridge of the nose. He's giving Cactus a taste of his own medicine.
Takes one heck of a man to put his mouth on Cactus Jack's nose. Into the ropes. And there we go.
And there's the man who will sacrifice his body in wrestling more than anyone I can ever remember. No disregard for pain, and I don't mean his partner.
Well, on the nose this time from Cactus Jack.
And look at those trunks and legs on Max Payne.
This is one weird tag team, but one very effective.
Max looks like he's wrestling in his underwear.
Yeah, he does. He may be. Here's the tag, Tony Mello.
He might have got to the building late. Just decided to slip him on over the top. Big clothesline.
Mella, fine competitor, strong athlete. But look with ease how Max Payne picks him up and down. To be the tag team champions of Super Brawl Sunday, February 20th, they must defeat Sags and Knobs, two of the roughest men the sport has ever seen. It is going to be nothing like a wrestling match. It's going to be a fight.
You know what I think will be interesting? Missy Hyatt, right? The manager for the Nasties.
Yeah.
She loves to get out and distract the opponents, right?
Right.
Be it sexual, the whole thing. I don't think she'll have the guts to try that with Cactus and Max Payne.
That's a good point.
So I think Misty's going to be neutralized.
Very good point, and that may happen. And that'll be coming up on pay-per-view, Sunday, February 20th. One of our many matches. And a head first goes Tony Mello. The tag has been made, and Max Payne is hovering. He's going to put on that painkiller, or that Japanese-type submission armbar.
Waiting for the opening, grabs the arm, falls into it, bends it back, and I'll tell you what, Knobs and Sags better be ready for that move.
No doubt about it. Max Payne and Cactus Jack focused on being the World Tag Team Champions. They may not be the prettiest.
Look at that. One of them bang, bang, and the other one's talking to Mother.
Cactus! please.
It's hard to believe that there is a mother for those two out there, Tony.
Everybody's got a mother.
Are you sure? Let's go back to replay. There's Cactus Wham. Face first into the mat. Here's Big Max Payne setting up for the painkiller. And yes, indeed, they both have mothers somewhere, Tony.
That's right. Everyone does.
And only a mother could love them, too, probably.
Speaking of only a mother could love, we take you now to Mean Gene Okerlund.
I bet he's got a mom, too.
I bet he does.
All right, fans, here's the date I want you to circle on your calendar. Sunday, February the 20th, 1994. Super Brawl on pay-per-view cable TV. Arn Anderson, I know a lot of fans at World Championship Wrestling have welcomed you back with open arms. You have a very important date, a very important appointment at Super Brawl. You're going to be facing the World Television Champion, this outspoken and pompous Englishman, Lord Steven Regal. Keep in mind, he has Sir William in his corner, but Arn, after all, you've been there before.
Well, Gene, I'm not going to be so pompous as to come out here and claim a victory, because I know after the events of 93, anything that can happen usually does. What I am going to say, however, I've always been labeled an underachiever, or should I say an overachiever. A lot of people said for many years I didn't achieve my potential, and then for a lot of years they said, well, he overachieved. He did things without extra special size or strength or speed or good looks. He just got in there, became a student of the business, and dug in. You're exactly right.
You know, you talk about Lord Steven Regal. You talked about Murphy's Law. Here's one for Murphy's Law. Anything can happen and will happen as long as Sir William is around.
Well, I think at this point, to swat me in the head with an umbrella is anticlimactic as to what I've been through in the last few months. So, my friend, gentlemen's gentlemen know their place. They stand at ringside and they supervise. You want to get involved, then I'm going to get you all the way involved. Trust me.
All right, it's Super Brawl. Maybe a little tea and crumpets for Lord Steven Regal. I doubt that. I thank you, Arn Anderson. Don't want to cut you short, but I know it's going to be a big one. And folks, you can see it all on pay-per-view cable TV. Call your local cable company right now regarding availability. Arn, I thank you.
My pleasure.